I'd like to say as I look out tonight, what a good crowd. And like Randy said, I remember when I was small, leaning on the everlasting arm, and it echoed tonight in here like it used to, because we got folks in the house. And we appreciate all you folks coming out and being with us. And it's just good to be a part of the revival service tonight. And thank you for having us. We're going to try. My God made it all. Summer's gone and winter's a-coming. Spring all around and snowflakes are falling. And there's talk all around that God is dead. But I see God everywhere. Yeah, I see God. Trees that grow so tall, and who made the grass that grows so small, and who made the air we love to breathe.
World of worries. Gonna trade my troubles for a crown.
That didn't sound good. We hadn't made but three CDs in, what, 50, 60 years. But anyway, welcome. Yeah, yeah. We do be a Doug McKenzie from Carthage on the banjo, and we're glad to have Doug. He's also a good Christian man. Goes to Middle Cross Baptist Church down in Seven Lakes. So give Doug a hand.
Throw your love.
does this is entitled Wings of Your Love.
I didn't come here in my Sunday best, but you said whosoever will. I thought it was time that I say hello to an old friend who knows exactly how I feel.
Just a few minutes, but I'm going to get a book and do this song for this folks. Hadn't done this in a while, but I'm going to do it for these folks from Lighthouse Baptist Church. They come a long way tonight, and I appreciate them, and I appreciate Lighthouse Baptist Church. It was always real good to hammer this home, and I hope to go back there one day again. So I think I got most of the verses. I'll do two here. I got the place that I'm standing is thirsty ground, and the well is empty, and the grass is brown. The fields are dried up, no more to gain. What I wouldn't give for some pouring rain. Pouring rain is always free, but the water of heaven inside of me. And when I'm soaked to the root, I never be the same. What I wouldn't give for some pouring rain. Thank you. so far in a barren land, pulling away from your loving hand. I'm in so much trouble, Lord, in so much pain, and what I wouldn't give for some pouring rain. Pouring rain is always free, but the water of heaven inside me. And when I'm soaked to the root, I'd never be the same. No. What I wouldn't give for some pouring rain. And when I'm soaked to the root, I never be the same. What I wouldn't give for some pouring rain. What I wouldn't give for some pouring rain.
Songs for you, and then some more folks from the church will come up and sing. So y'all pray for us to see.
All right, we'll try this. Black mist of night, burst off.
and sing for us. So y'all pray for us this evening.
Y'all pray for me. I can read.
Yeah. she likes to sing as much as we do, and we're always talking about different things in our churches going on in communities, and she's got to come back there tonight, and we appreciate her coming there to hear us. And so she gave me this song to sing, and she said, you guys need to do this. And I said, okay. So anyway, we worked it up, and I hope we don't disappoint Ms. Fields. So the title is, How Long Has It Been? If you know it, please sing along.
And don't listen to us, listen to the words.
Amen.
Yeah, beautiful words.
Walk with the dove and fell.
In Revelation 21, verses 10 and 11, first of all, John writes, "And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain, and showed me that great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God, having the glory of God, and her light was likened to a stone most precious, even like a jasper stone, clear as crystal. And I saw no temple therein, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are the temple of it. And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon to shine in it, for the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. And the gates of it shall not be shut at all by day, for there shall be no night there. And there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defileth, neither whatsoever worketh abomination or maketh a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's Book of Life."
Jesus over there. is shining, no more burdens to bear. Where the sun is always shining, no more burdens to bear.
You know, David writes in the, I guess, the most well-known psalm in all of the psalms, Psalms 23. He said, yea, though I walk through the valley, and I want you to notice the words, through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. And then at the last verse in that psalm, he contrasts that temporary walk through the dark valley with the fact that he's going to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Well, this psalm, it's a psalm too, I guess, takes up that thought. And the song is called, I'll Never Walk in the Valley Again. There's coming a day when the trials of this life will be over and we'll never walk through another dark valley. We're going to be with him forever. I'll never walk in the valley again.
Many times here in life, I walk through dark valleys, and I question, oh Lord, when I don't understand. Then I hear Jesus say, my child, just keep looking. For the next hill, there's a beautiful land. Someday I shall stand on the top of Mount Zion, and I'll get to look into Canaan's fair land. I'll sing and I'll shout when I reach that city. No, I'll never walk in the valley again. Someday I shall walk through death's lonely valley, but Jesus, my Lord, will hold to my hand. Yes, thanks be to God, it will be just a shadow. When on top of Mount Zion I stand, someday I shall stand on the top of Mount Zion, and I'll get to look into Canaan's fair land. Sing and I'll shout when I reach that city. No, I'll never walk in the valley again.
I'll listen to some of the testimonies. Really, the ones that have been given every night this week, it seems somebody has remembered how things used to be back in the old days here at the church. And that carried my thoughts back to way back yonder. Vicki and I had just gotten saved, and we were working with a youth choir at Putnam. And we brought our youth choir over here, and Jimmy Garner was leading the wonderful youth choir you folks had, and maybe you still have a good youth choir. I say had because it was back in our day, but you had a great youth choir back then. And I can remember Jimmy Garner leading Pass It On, It only takes a spark to get a fire going. And I can just see him leading it and hear the good singing that you folks had. And it just blesses me to be able to come back to this church after all these years. We were in our early 20s then. We're not in our early 20s anymore. But it's just a blessing to be here with you folks and to be able to sing. We're going to sing our last song here. It's just one of the old hymns of the church. The song's called At Calvary, just a little different arrangement of it maybe, but you'll still recognize, not so changed that you won't recognize the song. We love to sing the old hymns. We sing a lot of them, our group does, and we just maybe arrange it a little different. Hope you enjoy this song as we sing about Calvary.
Years I spent in vanity and pride, caring not my Lord was crucified, knowing not it was for me he died on Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary. By God's word at last my sin I learned. Then I trembled at the law I spurned, till my guilty soul imploring turned to
Calvary. Oh, the love that drew salvation's plan.
Oh, the grace that brought it down to man. Oh, the mighty gulf that God did span at Calvary. Was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burden soul found liberty at Calvary. Oh, and now I've given to Jesus everything. Now I gladly own him as my king. Now my raptured soul can only sing of Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There, my burden soul found liberty at Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free at Calvary.
Tonight we're going to do one called What the Lord Has Done For Me. kind of a personal testimony, but set to music and a good one. And then we're going to sing Bow the Knee, another new song that has touched many lives. It's a good, solid message. So pray for us as we sing.
I can't tell you how he paints a
our choir would come on up. We're going to join these folks. Come on up. Anybody from our choir, come on up. We, as a young man here, I remember the Comer family. The Comer family coming to sing here. Miss Helen, you remember that back there, right? Yeah. The Comer family used to come about every year for revival. And of course, the Comer family is a pretty large crowd, and they've got a lot of influence now, descendants in this church and Needham Grove and Beulah and Aiken Ridge, and the list goes on. Jan, if you want to come up here and sing with us now, come on. You'll know this one. Come on. They always, I was hoping Arnold would be here tonight, because they always sung this song every time. Of course, Miss Ethel, a tremendous impact in our church here. Sharon, you want to come and sing with us? You come on now. They would always sing this song. And if you folks that are as old as I am or a little bit older, you'll just about see them up here as they gathered. The sanctuary was different back then. You know, the choir was over here. The Amen Corner pulpit was a little bit closer to you all then. Didn't have these pews right here. But you can hear them singing this song, I believe.
And nobody can play it like Miss Helen. Yes,
Lord God, don't weaken the will.
think we should go buy a bus? We're thankful that Ken and Sherry are going to come and have a song before the pastor comes.
We're going to sing what the offertory was tonight. First time we remember that as Sandy played, we'll try to sing it for you.
Surely the presence of the Lord.